today. Not a bad afternoon. A little bit, muggy out there. Something interesting. You know, 7 years ago to the day, Hurricane Katrina.
That's right.
Just north of where Tropical Storm Isaac is, and going to follow almost an identical path.
That's right. Right.
Isaac could of Katrina. So very interesting. Now I should note, Hurricane Katrina already had winds at 100 miles an hour at this time 7 years ago, where Isaac at 60. So it is a little bit weaker, but something very fascinating, and a lot of things starting to work towards making Isaac a stronger storm. We'll show you that in a second. This evening, we still have a few showers across our area as well. Nothing drought busting out there, but a couple of nice little showers that are falling. The majority of the, or the biggest concentration, I should say, are down towards the south in Hays County, also in Caldwell County. Got a couple of showers in between San Marcos and Lockhart. Not a whole lot showing up on the lightning counter there. In fact, zero strikes in that area. We've also got a couple of showers moving just to the north of Wimberley as we look up into Williamson County. Got this little cluster of showers that's also just outside of Taylor as well. I'll lapse that for you. You can see those showers are generally moving off towards the north. Northeast at about, or north northwest, I should say, at about 5 to 10 miles an hour. So may see a few sprinkles, also a couple of those also just off towards the west of Austin. Now, satellite and radar this evening showing that we do have a line of showers up towards the north. We do have a boundary across north Texas this evening, and this is going to continue to move southward. This is good because this will be a focal point for us to see some showers again tomorrow as it moves closer into our area. We'll also shift our winds around, and we'll keep a chance of rain in the forecast again for Tuesday before this boundary kind of slides off and fades out of our area. Temperature wise, most of the readings are in the low 90s this evening. We've got 99 still though out in Llano, 95 right now in Burnett. Back in the tropics, Tropical Storm Isaac officially just the eye of, or the center of circulation, I should call it, is just to the south of Key West, Florida right now with winds at about 60 miles an hour. It's still moving off towards the west northwest at about 16 miles an hour, and the pressure has dropped now to 992. Now, forecast models continuing to try to push this system farther to the west. I've put the official plot right here and showing that being a category 2 strength storm at landfall near Gulfport in Mississippi. However, should note, there's a couple of forecast models that take this thing well off towards the west into Texas, into East Texas. You notice two of these models in towards the Houston area. So we're going to be keeping our eyes on this system very closely. Official forecast track, again, still takes it east of New Orleans, although the path gets pretty wide from the Florida Panhandle into central Louisiana. This area right in here is the loop current, or the current of the very warm waters across the Gulf of Mexico, and that's where we're going to see that strengthening with this system once again. At this point, I think it is going to make landfall somewhere Mississippi, Louisiana, but we are going to be keeping our eyes on this system for the next couple of days, because if it does happen to follow one of those farther western tracks, that could affect our weather later this week. 76 expected tonight. We'll see 97 tomorrow with a few isolated showers and thunderstorms developing. Call for about a 30% chance tomorrow, 20% chance on Tuesday. Again, this forecast reflects no effects of Isaac except for drier air at this point. 98 expected Wednesday, 99 on Thursday, and 100 for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Again, if that system does shift farther west, we may have to adjust this forecast.